However, there could be some potential negative effects with people using psilocybin. Could you touch on perhaps some unusual experiences?
Yes, so it's very important to understand that there are risks, very real risks associated with exposure to psilocybin. So in our studies at Johns Hopkins in a therapeutic context and when we are doing studies in healthy volunteers, we very carefully screen our volunteers. We develop rapport with them. The drug is given under a very tightly supervised and supportive context, and we do aftercare with them. Why do we do this? So the reason that we do this is because, unfortunately, psilocybin can produce some very difficult, long-lasting, and potentially harmful effects. So number one is that under the influence of psilocybin, people can have panic or fear reactions, and they can end up engaging in dangerous behavior. And it's uncommon, but it's not unheard of, to read reports where people run out into traffic, jump out of windows, you know, flee in ways that get themselves or other people into trouble. Two is that there really is concern, and this is more serious than just the panic, there really is concern that in some individuals, exposure to psilocybin and other compounds of this serotonergic hallucinogenic class can precipitate enduring psychiatric illness. The worst possible case would be precipitation of psychosis or schizophrenia in someone who's already vulnerable to that disorder. And that's a lifelong, irreversible disorder that is disastrous for someone. Other than that, there's some people who report persisting PTSD-like syndrome, depression, and anxiety disorders. So we're very concerned about that, and it's one of the reasons we screen people very carefully and support them through these kinds of experiences. We just recently have conducted and are continuing to collect data on an online survey asking people about the most difficult experiences they've had with psilocybin. And what we're finding is that most people are reporting experiences when it's isolated to their most difficult experience. They're reporting experiences that are among the most difficult that they've ever had in their lives, and very often the single most challenging experience. So there's nothing easy about these experiences. But the more sobering statistics out of this survey is that anywhere from about 3% to 10% of people are reporting persisting effects that look like some kind of persisting psychological harmful consequence. So some of these people never have been in therapy before and have sought out psychological counseling for fearful reactions or anxiety disorders or paranoia after the session with psilocybin. And they attribute, they're seeking that out to the psilocybin session. About 6% of people report a decreased sense of well-being. And so while these compounds may have great therapeutic potentials, they're also significant risks.
Right, right.